Alex Hirsch is the man who created Gravity Falls. I only say that because I had to Google the guy myself. I'm just like, who the heck is Alex Hirsch? Oh, him. Okay, fair enough. I was gonna be like some famous artist or something like that, but no. The name did sound vaguely familiar, but you know. There are so many people on Earth, you can't remember them all. There's more people on Earth than Pokemon. There's more people on Earth than Yu-Gi-Oh cards. Alright, but let's see how he becomes a Pokemon. This should be interesting, to say the least. Would he be one of the legendaries? Maybe he'll be the one to beat Bill Cipher. Or not Bill Cipher, whatever the heck. We ran into at the
fair. Maybe I should know this, but what exactly is an Ultra Beast?
A Pokemon, but an alien. I think Deoxys is an Ultra Beast, technically. It is from space. But not from Ultra Dimension, eh. Oh, yes, there were.
But some people suspect that part of what makes the Hoax region so bizarre is some connection to Ultra Wormholes and Ultra Beasts.
That's what the professor is. There's also some Ultra Beast in Pokemon Philosopher, but I don't remember the name of the region off the top of my head. Tours of fake
experiments. But this ugly creature thing could be an Ultra Beast?
Who knows, dude?
But whatever it is, the tracks
end up there. I just like how he calls everyone dude.
You follow Cordelia's lead and jump into the wooded thicket. Inside, you do not find an Ultra Beast, but instead, there is just an unfortunate-looking man.
Wah! What are you doing here?
Isn't that a gym leader from Gen 6, the grass-type gym leader?
Avert your gaze.
What kind of hideous creature is that?
Oh, barf. It's just so...
Wait! I'm not a creature. I'm a person.
I know!
Oh, you're just a very unattractive man.
It's just mean.
I was this close to attacking him.
Tobert... We don't have any legendaries, but somehow we sent out a Groudon.
A reporter in town?
They wouldn't put me on TV, and I got fired. My face was deemed a public health risk.
You have a face for radio.
Makes complete sense to me.
Go to Goldenrod City. They have a great radio tower there.
This is what my life has become. But I finally had some luck come my way. I found something out here that has to be worth a lot of cashola.
He pulls out the device component that had crashed nearby, and you can see that...
Yeah, that'd be worth a pretty penny, but will Grunkle Stand pay it? He'd try to finagle a price.
Oh, I need this! You're just going to take this back to that fraud, Professor Pines. We all know he's up to no good.
Nobody talks.
We can't rule that out with Grunkle.
Like all right, Tobert, we're just gonna have to kick your butt.
That's what you think will happen. But after spending all this time in the woods, I've become quite the grass-type specialist.
Oh, really?
All right, dude. You want to see if you can go 3 for 3 on taking these pieces from people?
Of course, it's all down to us. Main character powers, activate!
Okay, this isn't a super well-known cactus Pokemon, but we're taking a look at the Cactus Cat of America.
Because of course there's a cat cryptid. There's a cat version of everything.
Cactus-like tail and is covered with spiky.
We Americans love our cats.
Obviously a little grass type makes sense.
And granted, the rest of the world does too, especially Egypt. They loved cats before it was cool.
Smushed-faced, grumpy cats out there. We get a wonderfully round design, which definitely feels different enough from all of the other existing cat Pokemon out there.
I like this thing more than Cacnea Maractus, unironically.
It uses its claws.
Although not just because cat.
Open cactuses and then comes back later to drink the fermented juice. But we'll really run with that concept when we get to the evolution. Okay, let's meet.
It reminds me of Spike, the failed starter or Pokemon from Pokemon Amber, in a way. You can kind of see it too, right? I'm not crazy. I like the shiny is purple, kind of watermelon-y colors, in a way. Am I crazy? I'm probably crazy.
On rare occasion, once it has bonded with a trainer, Kitty Cat have been observed smiling and showing affection. The ability is Sap Sipper, to reference it drinking the fermented sap, so that boosts its attack stat whenever it's hit by a grass-type attack, and the hidden ability is Chlorophyll. It definitely looks pretty grumpy, but you're not sure if that's just how its face is, or if it's bummed that it has Tobert as its trainer. Anyway, Kitty Cat is a slow mixed attacker, but it isn't too tough to faint. Tobert sends out his next Pokemon.
Poor
All right,
fool.
I'm gonna have some fun with this one, sure.
What the
this
Bigfoot?
Is a monopod, that one.
To be fair, if it's cryptid region, Bigfoot was a law. Let's be real.
We're also gonna go in a Bigfooty direction.
Like, one of my favorite depictions of Bigfoot is the SCP-1000 version.
To Alex Hirsch, the creator of Gravity.
You turned him into Bigfoot? I guess you're gonna send out to any kind of, you know, cryptid. Why not the most famous one?
And I felt like we needed
or one of the most famous,
so,
anyway.
Our little monopod gets Alex's cartoony goatee, wild poofy hair, and the eye bags of a perpetually working creator. That's coming from one artist who works too much to
yeah.
Oh, and the red plaid shirt that he wore nonstop during the creation of Gravity Falls is referenced
the Mick Foley shirt.
Pattern.
I'd like to call it. Mick Foley only had one shirt, and he wore it for like freaking 50 years. That's hyperbole, but if you ever seen like cartoon characters are wearing the same shirt over and over again, that was Mick Foley IRL.
This is Hirschhop, the foot Pokemon.
Nice.
Sightings of this elusive fighting type.
It's a fighting type? Fighting grass. That's not too popular.
Locals suspect that there are only a handful of this Pokemon, and that they wander the land.
I like the shiny, although I feel like it could have been red to reference the shirt. Although that might be referencing the shirt, and I'm going crazy.
Occasionally pushes itself too far. Any trainer fortunate enough to
its special attack is ass. Its speed's pretty decent, though. Could be worse.
Ability is something new. I'm calling Tough Toe, so that boosts all of the kicking moves. I mean, it
somehow it learns Blaze Kick.
And the hidden ability is Technician.
Nice, I like it.
Pretty neat little Pokemon, so hopefully you are lucky enough.
I'm taking it back to the days of Ubi with the foot character.
Across the Hoax region, Hirschhop has some pretty devastating kicks to contend with, but you do eventually manage to knock it out. Two Pokemon down, two
one
more to go.
Oh, two to go. Okay, we're moving up in the world. Ooh, I apologize.
The Mandrake root was the first one to pop into my head.
Why wouldn't it be?
These are actual plants.
It was even in Harry Potter.
Hallucinogenic and
that's why they got so popular.
But
this reminds me of Krikatoon in all the right ways.
Kind of look very human sometimes. But they're, you know, they're present throughout folklore, magic and witchcraft, and even into modern portrayals of the plant. You know, like it puts you to sleep when it screams, or it straight up petrifies you. Fun stuff.
Or it just screams and you want to commit
another singing
harm. I don't know.
Not able to.
The point is, it hurt. It's yellow's life.
This is one of my favorite classes to play, the bard. Ah, you gotta love being a bard. All the charm and schmarm and boosting up your buddies that anyone could ever want. These
are you the smelly old bard of Genshin?
Pretty darn well.
Whatever Paimon called him.
Meet Ludralu, the bard.
It kind of looks like if Krikatoon and Goodra had a baby.
Poking out of the ground, many people.
Although I still like it. This is easily one of my faves for this episode.
Ludralu loves to.
Not to say anything bad about Alex Hirsch. Just we're going off of opinions here.
To accompany itself with music.
I imagine this thing does not evolve because it looks like a single stage of Pokemon, you know?
Do all they can to help out their friends. Its ability is...
Whoa!
The guard, so that reduces.
Look at that HP stat and that special defense. This thing is going to be the Chansey of the region.
Soundproof and serene grace. Ludralu is one of the bulkiest Pokemon in the Hoax region.
Easily.
So it takes a while to chip away at it. But Ludralu really shines in double battles. So luckily here, it's at a bit of a disadvantage, and you weather its weaker attacks and take it down.
Mm.
Tobert looks very.
That's how you balance out the tanky Pokemon. Their attack stat's pretty bad. Oh, we're getting evolution now. Okay. Whomping Willow.
As a reminder, Canitrop was based on the various carnivorous plant cryptids. So this evolution is mainly the man-eating tree of Madagascar. But we're pulling in some imagery from an episode of Gravity Falls 2.
Why not? That region is based on
Mabel's dream world, which momentarily transforms into a horrifying nightmare version, is one of those deliciously dark moments.
It's horrifying. I want to watch it again.
In the back of my brain. I just love the dark stuff that the Gravity Falls.
The uvula being a Pokemon there too is creepy in all the right ways. It also reminds me of the SpongeBob SquarePants movie, the first one, with that ice cream lady.
Gives us the formidable mono grass type, as I do want to make sure there are plenty of powerful mono types in the region. Okay, let's go ahead and say hello to Candivore.
Ooh, the sap Pokemon. Perfect name, though.
What initially appears to be leaves on this tree Pokemon are actually countless globs of super sweet and sticky.
I was expecting the souls of the damned, to be honest. Special defense is insane. HPs and special attack aren't too bad either, but it is an evolution, so it makes sense.
Eyes, those amongst its branches are actually decoys, as its true face is hidden below.
Ah, that's the tiny thing in the mouth is.
And that lowers the opponent's evasiveness whenever they enter battle, and the hidden ability is still sticky hold.
Hence why the eyes aren't blinking, but the true ones are.
But you manage to pull through and take down Tobert's last Pokemon. Cordelia walks over and takes the device component out of his hands.
Oh, I have nothing again.
You're on a roll. Color me impressed. Let's get this back to Grunkle Will.
Let's make fun of the man who's down in his luck. This will come back and, you know, karma's later.
That cool with you, dude?
You nod to Moose, and everyone heads out. As you're leaving, you can hear Tobert mumbling to himself as he kicks at some moss.
Now he's got a leaf named Leaf in his head.
Be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you are enjoying this series. There is a new puzzle added to the Discord server, so check out the video.
This was a good episode that I checked out, as I always say in these things.
Fun if you have not done that already. All right, I will catch you in the next one. Later, nerds.
But we just unnecessarily mean to this guy who's down his luck and life seems to hate. I never really a fan of those moments, just that the character's like, yeah, it's that your life is terrible for you. Well, F you. You should have thought about that before you chose to be ugly. What? I mean, I can't say I've never done something similar IRL, but it's still like, dude, aren't you supposed to be the heroes? I mean, it's okay if the, I mean, if the kids do it, that's one thing. They're kids, but the teenager's like, come on, guys. Let's be real here. Although teenagers are assholes, too. Ah. And again, I guess in the Gravity Falls thing, everyone's kind of an asshole. But I guess that's to be realistic to real life. I don't know. But poor dude just down his luck, fired from his job, luck, living in the forest. And he's not even a bad guy or something like that, like a jerk or something. It just, he's down his luck. It's just like, hey, we're going to steal you the one thing that can get you back in life. No! What did I do to deserve this? His Pokemon were cool, though. I like the Alex HIRSCH Pokemon, of course. It makes sense that you have to respect the original creator. He wasn't going to be with some random Pokemon. Might as well be a legendary. But he also decided to go with one of the more famous cryptid Pokemon, cryptids in general. The tree Pokemon was greatly disturbing, too. It was like, oh, Whomping Willow sort of thing. It was kind of like that thing from Harry Potter. Just like, so what if the tree beat the crap out of you? I know trees that move aren't a new concept of fiction, but just, it's always one of my favorite, just like, and then the tree moved. Suddenly, the tree moved. Oh, help! Go away! But of course, the tree couldn't. Points if you get the reference. But what was I thinking? The guitar Pokemon was cool, too. I like its design. It's a nice little turtle with some guitar mixed in for good measure. And looks nice and fun, I guess. Kind of reminds me of a Looney Tunes character in a way. Or something like that. Looks very cartoony, but in the right way. And, of course, the other one is good, too. What was the other one? I forgot. Oh, yeah, the Cactus Cat. The Cactus. That was a good one as well. I think that's probably my favorite for the cactus designs. Of course, the one is being Cacnea, which was at least played by James in the anime, and Rakdos exists. Ironically, by being the most forgettable Pokemon, it's also the most memorable, because if you say, what's the most forgettable Pokemon? Rakdos. Well, if you remembered it, then it wasn't forgettable, now was it? I couldn't tell you the most forgettable Pokemon, because I've forgotten it. But yeah, I guess that's going to be a thing. What do you think is the most forgettable Pokemon? Let me know in the comments below. And granted, if you say it, you could say, like, well, can't be that forgettable, but you probably Googled it. But anyway, yeah. What do you think? Did you enjoy? Did you not? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, thank you to Fruit VR for giving me permission to watch this series. And I hope you all, link to the channel in the description. And thank you all for watching, and hope you had a good day and a better tomorrow. Until next time, later.